Hey everybody, happy Stampiversary to me! I am so glad that you're here today. It's a really special day, a very special day for me and Stamper from StamperDog.com. Hey, I'm Ann Klemmer. Let's get started. Stamper, come. We started totally different today. And, you know, sometimes I just need that extra 5 minutes. You know, I do my best to start on time, but I need that extra 5 minutes. So I'm not going in here. Yeah, well, I'm going to do that anyway. I am so glad to have you here with me because today, oh my goodness, and she's here today. Hey, we got Chrissy. She joined my team yesterday. I love the email she sent me. It said something about who cares about those teams. I'm joining the Stamper Dog team. Yeah, we didn't call it that. We called it, golly, are you in the frame today, Stamper? Oh, here, that's my stamp door. Yeah. And it is now official. I am so very happy. Oh my goodness. Yeah, we've had a really busy morning. I'm not used to that. I like to get up and then kind of, you know, ease my way into the day, you know. It's funny. I didn't start drinking coffee until I started working from home, right? All those years, I would probably have a Diet Coke around 11, right? But now it's, oh yeah, I don't really want to do anything technical until I've had a cup of coffee. Oh yeah, let's take a drink on that. Yes, this is just water. It's 22 years. I'm serious. You know, I've mentioned this to Shelley Gardner on more than one occasion. I can't believe I've done this for this long. Even like 7 years ago, I can't believe I've done this for this long. Because any job I've ever had, I usually stay maybe not more than 5 years. I think I did once. No, that was when I worked for myself. Anytime I've worked for myself, I've worked longer. But for the most part, I only work somewhere, you know, 5 years tops, maybe only two or three. My dad always said that, you know, you owe your employer 2 years because it takes time to train you and to get good at your job and so that they can, you know, get paid back for investing in you. Okay, I get that. And I can remember one job I took and it was for someone I really, really liked, but it was the second day there and I knew I'd made a mistake. But I did do my 2 years only because it, as it worked out, it helped me build for everything I did after that. He sent me to school. It was like a night school. It was funny. His wife and the office manager were in the classes behind, and they'd sit at the back of the room, and I'd sit at the front because I wanted to learn Word Perfect. And I, oh yes, and that's really, I've taken that, and those were only like, it could have been a week or might have been 2 days or whatever, but I just wanted to learn how to work a computer program. And so I'm dating myself. I still love Word Perfect. Yeah, do. Yes, I do. Ask Barbara, because she's a word person. It's one of the few things we disagree at the base level about. But I can adjust. See, look at this. Yeah, that's a quite a while, this. And by the way, you said, you know, my interpretation of what you said was that you really didn't want a prize, but I ordered you a prize and it was the black matte dots. And but because they're, you know, they're primo, they're on back order. And so when that comes in, I'm going to mail that to you. So, yeah, and my husband is quite the opposite. He worked, he was in the military. Hold on, I now have to ask him. Hold on. 22 years, so I don't have to ask. he was in the military for 22 years, and then he worked at the Target Distribution Center for 24. Now, I'm sure he might have done something before that. I don't know. But for me, no. I just kind of, see, look at Kathy. We have something in common there because, yeah, and I don't, what I like about it, you don't have to update it that much, and it still keeps trudging along, and there's certain things it just does easier and better. And but you know, a lot of these things, it's down to the marketing. That's why we don't have, we never really got into Sony Beta tapes, because they were really actually a better thing, but VHS advertised better. Those of you who can remember back in those days, you know. So anyway, yeah, we're so glad to have Chrissy here on the team. And she just fits in because she knows a lot of you who come to this anyway. Oh, yes. And, you know, we always want to do what Louise says. Yeah. Oh, see, and Marcy's another one. We're the yin and yang of job employment. You know, I could not do the, you know what? And I couldn't do that either, because there'd be just too many children funerals. Oh, see, and Beverly, oh my goodness. Now you guys are topping it. 39 years. Oh. Yeah, Cecil, he got out of the military right at the right time. I'm happy with that. So here's today's plan of attack. Whoop, make a card. Yeah. Yeah, well, you know, I'm going to remake a card that I found in my Pinterest, you know, page. And well, okay, the dog's Pinterest page. See, he didn't like that so much. He got up and left. Okay. He's like, "I am only working so hard." I saw this and I went, I've got to make that, because that is just the perfect card for this time. And it's going to be very easy, very, very easy. And I'm just going to show you, we're going to figure out what color base to make after the fact. How about that? And I want to use up some of this. I like it. I like it a lot. I like that free stuff that you can get. Oh, yeah. Oh, here. So here's the thing before here's the thing that kind of delayed me, and this what kept me up last night. I am so happy to those of you who shopped with us, and I'm sorry, but those of you with exact personalities are probably having a problem looking at this, or let's say a challenge looking at this right now. Yeah, all the mail for the sale has been picked up. It's all been picked up. Yeah, and you know what? Now that you mentioned, I started that thing about Shelly. Shelly was going, you know, I would say, I can't believe I've done this for so long. And she goes, well, and you've been married longer than that. Yeah, but I don't look at marriage as a job. It's an adventure. Well, just like being a stamina demonstrator is an adventure. When I started 22 years ago, you would not think that I would be you know, standing in front of this camera talking to you all over the place. In fact, Gail, if she's here, you know, she comes from France, and we have some people from down under that watch us. So, you know, and those of you on the replay, we love you too. So it just dawned on me, before I get started on this card, I might have to trip over something to get this. Hold on. I'm just going to grab something just so you have an idea. Oh, golly. Nope. It's not what I thought it was. It's not what I thought it was. I thought it was my old, you heard that fall, right? I thought it was my old success magazines that Stampin' Up. We used to have a publication, and the publication would come out every month, and I've had my picture in it. The dog's been in it. Yeah, I think we included the dog in the picture. I'm pretty sure. Anyway, it's just ideas. Well, now with the internet being what it is, and printing and mailing costs, yes, those mailing costs. Stampin' Up goes and they do it other ways, and they do it more often, right? And so here, this is not what I thought it would be, but this kind of shows you how things change, and then again they don't. Here's a stamp magazine from 2006. So yeah, and spring, and look at that, looks like an old Stampin' Up stamp right there. So I'm just going to turn to a page. Wow, we could make any one of that's somebody else. This is definitely an old Stampin' Up stamp. I know. Yes. Isn't that funny that I just opened it and I used to do this on the front. I wish we had that punch where it just goes and makes that little, you know, cut right there. I miss the magazine and then I don't. In fact, how about this? I'm going to put this down here, this right here, and I'll hold it up so you can see it better. Ooh. Try to get the focus. Oh, hello, Ann. Yeah, it's not. There we go. That right there, this stamp, that is an old Stampin' Up stamp. That's an old celebration stamp. How about that? That's funny that I just kind of went to that. Well, now I'm going to try to find one. Oh, look at, see, this is something that you could do. This isn't Stampin' Up stamps, but look at, oh, but look at how everybody looks different. You'd be lucky. You would be lucky to get to get all your kids to dress up like that for a picture these days. You know, they like to go outside and take them by a barn. And, you know, senior pictures aren't what they were 22 years ago either. So, yeah, look, see, you could still do that. You could still do that. I think this is Stampin' Up or something really close to it. Look at it, make a little coupon book. Yeah. So you can go through those old magazines and you know, I've kept them and I probably should ditch them now. Yeah. Oh my goodness, Louise says she has that magazine. Yeah, you just never know. I was thinking just before I came in, oh, we have some old Stampin' Success magazines. That's what they were called. Yeah. So yeah, see. You know, I think what people, when they are at a job for a long time, when you start thinking that you're indispensable, that's the time to go. Yeah, that's the time that, yeah, no, no, no. Okay, so here's the idea. And I'm not sure which one I'm going to use. I'm going to show you choice A and choice B, but we have to remember where we put them down. Yeah, over here. Yeah, we had a great time at the sale. We had a great time at the sale. We went and sold everything but three things. So, yeah. And boy, was I giving that stuff away. Diane, you're going to have something that I think you're going to like. So, what we're going to do is I cut this a quarter of an inch smaller. But, yeah, these are both 4 inches wide. And I may cut this down. So that is too big. That's a little too big. Yeah. This is going to be way different than the original card. Yeah. You're going to like it. It's something that I sent, Deb one and she approved. So yeah. So you will too. Yeah. Okay. So, let me go and I'm going to punch these through real quick and then we're going to see what we're going to do with that. But for those of you who have not yet, make sure you sign up for my birthday party, because there's a lot of things that go on this month. I got to tell you, there's, we just had Super Bowl Sunday. There's Valentine's Day. There's, and remember these, you know, it's not too late to get a Valentine stamp because you can use them for St. Patrick's Day. You know, those hearts make a great four-leaf clover. This might be too big a heart here, huh? We'll see. We're making a different one. Oh, I picked up the channel one. That was smart, Ann. That was smart. Okay, hold on. Hold that thought. I found the smaller heart, and it'll only take me a nanosecond to cut this. So, who watched the game, and did your team win? You know, we always root for the red team unless my team's playing. You know, yeah. I think this one's a little bit too small, but that's okay. It's going to give us more room. We were actually rooting for Kansas City for a couple reasons. That's a, you know, come on, I'm a Seahawks fan. I haven't forgotten Deflategate. But, you know, I mean, Tom gets his props. Tom gets his props, yeah. What was your favorite commercial? Okay. You know, now that I made this smaller, I could have done it with a smaller piece. How about that? Yeah, what was your favorite commercial? Oh, my goodness. I went and left it like that. Oh, you must have thought I'd gone to Texas or something. Now, look, at we can put this on and we can make it to where it doesn't show. And this is going to kind of be like the yes, they did. Why didn't Gronk do that well when he was on my fantasy football team? That's what I want to know. See, look at we can go and decide where we want this. I think that's good. I think that's good. We'll give it a look. That would not be something I would watch instead of the football game. I really like the M&M's commercial. I have to go back because we record it, and I have to go back and play that one again. And then we liked Flat Matthew. Yeah, that was very ingenious and took a lot of work. Yeah. Okay. You know, I only use this when I'm with you. So I know about where I'm going to cut it. Like right about there. And these are... Okay. If I just make it like 4 inches, that'll be more than enough, right? I can even do a little bit. And then I'm going to cut a little bit off of this side. Nothing too drastic. You know that this is how you do it, right? I mean, this is when you don't know how you're going to make it. Yeah. That's the way I would do it when I first started. I'm serious. When I first started as a demonstrator, I didn't even know how to put a layer on. I mean, I was like, what? Oh, really? Oh, I mean, I just went and folded a piece of cardstock and stamped on it and said, okay, here's my swab. It was really bad. I'm serious. I would pay for that. I'd pay $25. Well, it was kind of ingenious, you know, because you wondered how he was so flat, but the way it ended was perfect. The fact that he was flat and he got inside the chip machine and then it made him 3D and then he couldn't get out. But everybody likes the M&M commercial. I don't know anybody, you know, those guys, whoever does their marketing, great job, great job, great job. So see, I'm going to put this like right about there. And I don't think I'm going to. Okay, so this is where, what color? Oh, you're not looking. What color do you think we should do for the trip around there? See, and I really think a smaller one would be great, would be better. You know, I can do that really quick. Oh my goodness. Okay, now what was the one with Jimmy? Well, the Clydesdale showed up, but it was on somebody else's commercial. I'm like, whoa, wait a minute. Hold on, let's see. Okay. I think this is going to be better with this. I think it is. Just hold on with me. Because we know we're making this together, but what color base do you think we should use? Should we use the Poppy Parade? That's the red. I'm not going to get this in exactly the same place, so we'll see how it goes. I think it's time for new cutting place, but they're still cutting really well. You know you guys don't come here for the card. You just come here to have a good laugh. I'm thinking Poppy Parade, not, you know, I mean, I almost wore purple today, but you know, since it's my anniversary, I figured that. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Oh, pretty close. Pretty close. Pretty close. Not quite the same. This fits better. Maybe not. Yeah, I'm thinking red. And here's the other thing. It's a little bit late if we're going to feature this. But, okay, red, red. That doesn't look real. That doesn't look Poppy Parade to me. That doesn't look Poppy Parade to me. That looks more real red. That looks more real red. You know what? I can cut this smaller. Okay, so now someone's saying Bermuda Bay, but there's no Bermuda Bay is not in this shot. But I'll get it out just to. But I'll show you. Let's see. I'm gonna cough here. Okay. I have two mute. I can't even say it. Two mute buttons on this thing. See, this is, it's not this color blue, that's for sure. It's not that. We don't have pink. We're not featuring pink. Actually, I may just go and cut this down a little bit. Why do I think that fit better before? Maybe I cut it a little bit too. And we can always tilt it. There's nothing saying we can't tilt it. Okay, hold on, real red. This would be a good one to pick because it's already cut. See, that looks more like a real red to me. And in my monitor right there, it does not look real red. It looks, that looks more like Poppy Parade. Ah, this is a smaller one. Oh, wait. Granny Apple Green. Oh, Cherry Cobbler. That would even be darker. The blue of the flower. Hold on. This might be a little bit bright. But it is the right color. Isn't it funny how we go down this kind of path? And you just get, yeah, it doesn't really roll with that. Rolls like that. Now look at that, doesn't even go at all because you'd have to have the pink. Isn't that funny about how one little switch. I'm glad you like the red. I have to put a lot of paper away. My new way of keeping my script. Oh, that kind of works. But I do like it with the red. And I'm thinking that I'm going to go and cut this. Because I did in the original card, I do remember that. I'm taking a really good look at it. Because that's how I do these things. Taking a really good look at it. Close enough. Because I want it to be just the way I want it. Oh, look at there. I've got there. You have the yellow. I've decided that. And then this way I can get more of this in there. See? I would be more careful with this, except for that I have quite a bit of it. Yeah. Yeah, at the birthday party, we are going to be, well, last time we gave away almost $300 worth of stuff because, oh, there, see, there it is, there it is, there it is. Everybody's going for red, yep. Ah, plus, I already have it cut. There you go. So to be the safest way to do this, normally, you know, it would be nice to go and put dimensionals on, but I'd have to hold my mouth right and think really hard, right? Oh, goodness gracious, the dog has come back. You know, I don't care how I go and move that thing. He's not going to be in the frame. Now, can anybody tell you what bad thing am I doing right now? Because I can tell you. Yep. I can tell you. I'm putting adhesive on. Oh, there he turned. I'm putting adhesive on and I'm on top of good cardstock. Or many people do it on top of their project. And it makes me go, ah. Because I'm just convinced that they are going to go and accidentally get it on their project. And that's how those things happen. My rolly cart is over by the door because of what we had to go through for the sale, and I have not moved things yet. So this is a good thing to have. This is our little craft mat. And of course it has the Stampin' Up! Logo on it. I'm going to tell you that since I became a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, I can't tell you what I've bought that does not belong to us. Because I figure if there we go. Now, see, look it. Yep, that's right, Chrissy. See, now, by having this, it's not going to stick. See, it won't stick to that. And I've got adhesive that's going to stick outside there. So now we're going to put this one on. And the other good thing about this is when this doesn't want to start up for you, just go and pull it across here and now it will start for you. Okay. And I had a discussion about this. Now the other, and see, it's not on here either. You can see where I rolled, but there's no adhesive on there. And then if you're over here and I've got a little bit of, let's see how close I can get here. I have a little bit of adhesive right between, you know, it goes all the way down to here. Let's say that this was stuck again. I would start it on the adhesive and then go over. And yeah, and that would work. That would work. See, there it goes again. And you notice I don't do this as much anymore. I'm trying to go it like this. Oh, in fact, this might be a good, let's try this. A lot of, it's just finding that little sweet spot. When it comes up, the little webs come up, just go like that. And then you'll have a better chance of starting well next time. Ooh. This could be smaller. In fact, I'm going to cut this off now because you'd think I'd turn this. See, glue on your grid pad and then you put your card on the pad. Yes. And that's why I try to get people not to go and clean their brushes and stuff on your grid pad. Do it on like a scrap piece of paper or cardstock, because you'll be much happier. Because it's just that one time. You know, I have no idea where we're going with this. Well, I have an idea, but that's it. So this, I'm going to tell you, is 3¾ by 5¼. Okay? No, 3¾ by 5. Five. Just 5. Now, I'm going to cut this. Oh, this is cut on the, see, this was going that way when it was cut. I can tell. Can you? I don't even think it's the right size. In fact, I know it's not. For one thing, the way it went. Yeah. Let me go and cut a piece. I thought it was a half sheet, but it's not. And I don't like the way, well, here. It was not a half sheet. And it is now. Boy, I wish we still sold that guillotine cutter. The trimmer is great. The trimmer does things that you can't do with a regular guillotine cutter, like cut a circle, you know, cut the inside out of a. That's the big one. I wasn't going to do the big one. I was going to do the small one. That's fine. I was going to do the smaller one. Hold on. Boy, good thing I haven't been celebrating. Yeah, I grabbed the wrong one. Whoa, it's got adhesive on it now, I'll tell you that. Yeah, I can only cut so much because, you know, I don't want to have all these options cut and then you guys go, oh no, we want that color. Oh! Except for it's sticking to the bed of my trimmer or my cutter. See, I grabbed the wrong one. Boy and Clemmer. Oh, pay attention. See, it's a good thing that I don't work for someone else because I'd be fired by now. But don't you fire me. Make sure that you follow us and subscribe. Okay. Oh, that is. Oh. Just on the trimmer. That little blade, honey, that can puncture. Oh, that. Oh. Do you know what? The mini trimmer is nice to have. If they bring it out, then I guess that it's truly worthy, right? But yeah, it's not my go-to. It's only my go-to here because it's small and I can put my hand right on it. Okay, so see, I wanted, you're not looking. I wanted red butt here. I'm going to, and this, I'm going to tell you, has more blue in it. It has more blue in it. In my monitor, it looks like Poppy Parade, but I guarantee you that it is not. And I'm going to cut something I don't normally do. How about an eighth of an inch? Eighth of an inch bigger. Yep. No, 3/16. I'm just a wimp when it comes to that. 3/16 is so much easier to do than an eighth of an inch for me. See, this is going to be your man card. If I lay this on here, it's going to want to stick. Boy, try to do that on black. I dare you. I'm just kind of lay it down. It's not even straight, I don't think. Yeah, it's not. See, doesn't that little layer help? I know I have a white piece of paper here. It's so much better. Well, actually, we did have some mimosas last night. Well, my husband had mimosas. Yes, he did. Look at this here. I get this out, right? And now I have white on white. Oh, Ann Clemmer, what are you thinking? Okay, now this is the stronger one. And the reason why I'm doing that, you wouldn't have to, but it's because I have those strips of designer series paper. And that's going to give it a reason that it's going to want to pull away. If the, by the way, if the, the way that the, this one, the way that this one starts, you know, you have an issue with that, go for the Seal Plus, because it has little rivets. It has little lines in it. I don't know if you can see it here. Yeah, you can, right there. See down here, you can see those little lines, and that helps it to where it cuts. I'm only doing this so that I can get this one on here. Okay, everybody, hold your mouth right. Hope I cut it right. My finger's stuck to it. Yeah, when we do the Master Stamper videos. Okay, everybody, it's secret time. It's time for a secret about Anne, okay? I know. Yeah, and here it is. When I do my pre-recorded videos, they're all sped up because I am so slow. Yes, I am so slow. Now, one of the things that I forgot, that on the original card is white and real red, right? It's all white and real red. So this is totally different. But what I did was I went and did a bow right here. So we can still do a bow and just put it right there, but I tied a little knot around there. Yeah, jetting from the TV to the bed to here. Yes, that's right. So we're going to go, let's see, I have a smudge there. You probably can't even see it. Boy, that bothers me when I look at it in the monitor. It's like, that looks so orange. Oh my goodness. Yes, if you're going, they probably have to fumigate everything coming from a different country, no matter what country it is. And I know down in Australia, I know New Zealand is really, you know, locked down tight. I don't know about Australia, but I know everybody's, you know, doing their best to make sure we get rid of this. And we're almost through it, everybody. Just don't give up on those masks. So, okay, let's look at the stamp set. Let's look at the stamp. Now we finally look at the stamp set. Ooh, I wonder if there's something that fits on this, but that just dots it. Oh, yeah. Okay, you like that? Okay, so Jacqueline says that, yes, they're locked down tight. That's good. Just a little note, yeah. That would work. You're all heart. Ah. Ooh, just warm in here. Now with this, I'm going to tell you, especially with this one, you're going to want to lay it down. Boy, this is very, very plain. Too bad. Oh, not too bad. I'm not done yet. Okay. I could have, there's a lot of things I could have done. But you know, simple is good. Simple is good. And the most important, the best card is the one that your friend has, you know, or your loved one, or however you want to say it, your friend, your, here we go. Because I have a bad habit of not mailing them out. Yeah. I wonder if we put this up here. Ah. Maybe I'm defeating the purpose. Okay, so when you do these, you want to lay them down first. I like to put them a little off kilter so I'm paying more attention to where the stamp is. See, it's not straight on the block. Because if it's a little bit, it's easy to get a little bit off on the block, and then it's going to be a little bit off on your card. So if you go and put it on cattywampus, right, a little bit, just a little bit off, then you're going to be looking more at the impression and not at your block. Wow, where's that scrap of paper? Hey, here's something new that I found on Amazon. Look at this. I don't know why I did it, but we're going to come up with something for this clear post-it notes. There's this size and there's that size. See if we can get this through with... I know we have dies this small and we have punches this small. Let's try for the punch. Golly, and look at it, was dead on straight. Ah, that's fun. I'm gonna do another one over here just for the heck of it. If I try to get this down here and get it dead on straight. Oh, no, I don't want that side. I want this. See, that one's not, that one's like off a bubble. Just, yeah. Oh, welcome to my world. But look at. Perfecto Mundo. Yeah. Oops, sorry. My hand's in the way. Look at that. This was if I would just go and cut it. Yeah, clear post-it notes. And I don't know what I'm going to do with it because there's got to be like when we're masking or something, maybe that, you know, yeah. Whoa. Okay. Connie, you're going to have to tell us about this. A post-it note printer? Holy moly. Now I'm going to tell you again, got to do this. Because we're already full, half full from the people who were in it last time. And you know, we want to have more. We're doing it on Facebook so that it's going to go faster and you don't have to get dressed up. And everybody should be, normally I wouldn't do it this close to the other one, but I moved it as far away as I could and still stay in my birthday month. If I don't cut this out straight, you'll just have to forgive me. There's a link, I'm sure, on today's post. How to get there. Hold on, we're almost, I'm gonna surprise you with something. Yeah, I'm gonna surprise you with something. Look at this. I came over here and I dropped it along the way. No, I didn't. It's not there. Okay. We got one more little thing to do. And if this doesn't work, well, you know, we'll just call it good. It's kind of like a go-to thing. I just don't, but I think it's going to make all the difference. I think it is. Whoa. Anybody got a guess? Oh, we got a prize going off at the end. Yep. Yeah. In fact, I just came up with, okay, this is going to make all the difference. Look at what we did. Can you see it? The only thing is, look at, you can see where these are, if they're looking really close, yeah, they can look, they can see it a little bit. So yeah, in hindsight, oh, well, maybe not the best idea, but I just kind of like it having a little bit more, stuff. And that would tell you, if you're going to make this card, if you're going to make this card, go and run it through the texture before you put those backings on, because see, I want you to have like something that where they're, wow, this is so handcrafted, and not, this is so like thrown together. But we'll see how it works. We'll see how it works. Oh, wow. Okay. So here, so that everybody can see what she said, that, okay, first of all, oh, it works with your iPhone. Okay. Wonder, yeah, you know, they have some things out right now that only work with the iPhone. I'm still wondering when they're ever going to come out with something first for Android. Because there are more Androids than there are iPhones in the world. Well, you know what, Susan? I'm not sending it to that person who really cares. But I like to have it as good as I can, you know. I think do the best that you can and don't worry about it. Like, always double check which way the card's going. Okay, and then I liked it. Once I get it in the right spot, I had it in the right spot, and then I moved it. Oh, it works with Android too. And then she said it doesn't use ink. It uses thermal paper. But does it put the sticky part on it? Yeah, it probably doesn't put the sticky part on it. That's what our old two-way glue used to do. Yeah, okay. So now, okay, here we go. Here we go to save the day. Woo. Yeah, I gotta tell you, if I went and cleaned up, if I totally cleaned up my stamp room, then I'd probably be selling my home, which would mean I may not, you know, I might be changing to my status, you know. In any case, there's just a little note. Right? Because this is all textured and this is not. And to detract from that little extra layer stuff. Nothing does it like glitter. Now you could give this to a guy, right? This is like a, you know, what? Yeah, the mask. Okay. Yeah, they don't stand out. I'm only because I tend to look very closely at my work. And you know what? I do not beat myself up about it. Just like I weigh myself every morning just to keep my mind focused on, okay, well, you know, you might not want to have that froyo today, right? Just keep me focused, but I'm not going to obsess about it. Oh my goodness, I'm up 2 pounds. No, that means do not put that salt shaker in your hand. Oh my goodness, she says it's sticky on the back of the paper. Whoa. Next thing, they'll be having cell phones for everyone. So here we go. You know, just a little knot. I mean, we could do a great big thing, but I'm going to try the knot first. I'm going to make it really small. Stampin' Up, I miss these scissors too. Yep, I miss these scissors. Put that down a little bit. See, now where it was on the original card, it was like right there. Beep. And I tied it around. You could put, yeah, do anything. you could do anything, but it's time for a prize. So there you go. There's an idea for like a Valentine. This could say Valentine's. You could put it up here. That would be a good place, but I did make a whole lot of room down here. You could wrap a ribbon all the way across this, right? Before I put that down. You know, hey, I'm rarely finish a card, but I do like to try to give you ideas on how alternative ways so that you really get an idea for more than just one card, but several. And on this for the backing, you could just go, it's nice to pick something that you don't have a lot of. We could have gone with a really light blue that looks like really light blue, but this was nice. You saw the different ideas. So what I'm going to do, you know, not everybody has some of this cardstock, and I think what I'm going to do is cut some samples from it. So that, and I'll put them in the mail, and it, you know, anything that keeps it under 1 ounce, and that's usually like 6-7 sheets. So yeah, this is just I would like to get this in, and it doesn't even say, you know, it just says February. That's what it says. Yeah, you can put it up here. That, I don't know. It doesn't, you know, you could put it down here. You could put, but I kind of like it right there because that's where the original card had it. You know, it's just something simple because that's what we all need to do. We need to keep in contact with each other, and to go and, you know, keep the communication going because we're still not to where we can all hang out with each other yet. Except for like this, right? So let's go and you know, let's go pick. Oh, wow. There's a lot of chatting today. Okay. I'm going to get out a piece of paper because that's the only way. And I highly recommend that you email me. I'm going to tell you, email me your address if you go and win, because then it's easy. I just go to my email and go, her. Him, her, you know, yeah, and getting them in the mail and they're all done. How many? Well, oh, that's an old one. How many years? 22. That's, do you know, for years I used to say I was 22. Yeah. Yeah. They didn't believe it then either, but you know, yeah. Yeah. And I won't be telling you guys how old I am on the 17th either. So isn't that a Wednesday? I think so. Oh, I'm in trouble now. Okay, I'm looking for something that's sitting right next to me. Hold on 1 second. And I got to get a piece of paper out. Because actually, yeah, because you have to have your name on there, right? And then I have to get the email from you. So, yeah, easy peasy, Anne and the dog, right? So, Anne@stamperdog.com. Did my finger, did it go right along with it? Like, because I was looking at you. And I should be looking at this. Okay. I have paper here. Well, you know, I wrote on that, so I can. Yeah, we're going to do a lot of them. So if your name comes up twice, that's just not going to work. Oh, 166. Okay, great. I'm going to do 166. I'm going to do 107. And I'm going to, in a minute, I'm going to bring up all the names. I'm going to do 39. And I'm going to do 32. So that's four. So, hey. So talk amongst yourselves. Hooray! Talk amongst yourself. And hey, and if you're thinking of going to go, wow, hold on 1 second. Going shopping. But you know what? The thing you really should be doing is this. Yeah. Be like Chrissy. 160. Okay. We got one. I said 180, but there's only one. So, hey, the first one doesn't count because there's only, it was only 160. Well, now it's 165. So I'm going to pull another one here. Hold on. Yeah, Anne can't count. Okay, so you could see this. 28. Okay. Okay, so I'm back to this. Yeah. Oh, yeah. This. Because right now you not only get, you know, $125 worth of product, but you also get all those pieces of designer series paper that's not even released yet. Okay, one. How about this? Same person would have won anyway, even for that. Yeah, yeah. So here I'm going to tell you, here's the first one. And even if I have your email address, please send it to me, because like I said, then I get to woohoo
winner.
Then I get, then it's just easy for me to go and send it without having to look everywhere. Okay. 2, 4. Oh yeah. Oh, here's another one.
Winner.
Yeah. Woohoo. Connie. And hold on, 2, 4, 1, 2. Now this girl is so lucky. Oh my goodness. Winner. We're just gonna go like throw some confetti out there because she just keeps winning. And I'm gonna do this other one from the end. And it's going to be, whoa, hey. Yay, winner, winner.
Winner.
Who was number three? Who was number three? Who was the third one? The one between Connie and Kathy. See, look at, I've already got. And we're going to do one more. We're going to do one more, but I don't have it till tomorrow. I got to stock up on my coffee cards, right? I got to stock up on my coffee cards. So yeah. Hey, we got, see Susan, she got a mini, cut and emboss machine. I guess it was last month. So now we're starting on new month. This is your year. This is your year. There it was, Susan. That's what it was. Okay. So let's do one more. But now we got more. So now we do have 180. Okay. Thank you for hanging with me when I do this stuff where I have to talk and chew gum at the same time. Because like... It's just the way it is. And just the way it is, I can only do so much. 67. Okay. So back to this. You really got it. Whoa, no, not that. I hit something really. It's a, do you want to quit? No. Okay, so coffee. If I write it down, it works. Now I have to count 67, 2, 4, 6. And if it's a double winner, I'm going to let you do it. 1, 2, 3. I can't believe this. I could not make this stuff up. And the coffee card, it goes to someone who's already won. And I was just talking about how lucky she is. Yay. That's it. Yeah. There we go. Woohoo.
Winner.
And yeah, my slogan. So thank you for hanging out with me on my 22nd birthday. Well, Stampiversary. Yeah. My 22nd Stampiversary, you know, and I'm so glad because I've learned so much. I've talked to you about how I was a terrible stamper when I started, right? I've learned so much about paper crafting. I've met such wonderful people. I have a great group of people on my team. You should do that. Yes, you should. Yes, you should. And you know what? Even the real cool thing, I got this fabulous dog that I wouldn't have gotten otherwise. And you know, I've been able to, well, for me, you know, I never saw it for the first 5 years, but ever since then, I've been able to be blessed with a trip that I can take my husband on and reward him for being so supportive. So, hey, get on the bandwagon. My only regret is that I did not do it sooner, because, oh golly, if I would have done it a year earlier, where would I be now? This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from StamperDog.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun into your day. We'll see you Wednesday, 1 o'clock Pacific.